हाय स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ दिस इज द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, द न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ द रिवीजन सीरीज 21, दैट इज आई टेक मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। एज वी नो, वी स्टार्टेड रिवीजन सीरीज 2021 फॉर एसएससी स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम मे 28। नाउ वी सक्सेसफुली कंप्लीटेड द थ्री वीडियोज ऑन द इलेक्ट्रिक चैप्टर एंड विथ ग्रेट रेस्पॉन्स। ओके, सक्सेसफुली वी कंप्लीटेड दैट रिवीजन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कंप्लीटली। Right, now let us take the second chapter, that is physics 10th, that is magnetic effect of electric current, and this is also a very important chapter of class 10 physics. And in this video we cover and some of very easiest concept of this chapter. Okay, so see here students, this chapter is an first introduced in the 10th standard, and after that you have to face this chapter in the second PUC again with a deep explanation. But here we take the basic concept about the magnetic effect of electric current, right? So there are different effects of current is there, right? In the last chapter, electricity, in the last video of revision, we learn a concept that is a heating effect of electric current. And then heating effect of electric current, that is nothing but one property of current is that whenever a current is passed through a conductor or a charge is passed through a conductor or electrons are passed through a conductor, what happens? There is a heat is generated, and that is one of the property of current. Okay, and there is another property of a current, that is whenever a current or charge is passed through a conductor, what happens? The magnetic field is generated. Right, so for see here, I can take a conductor here, right? This is a conductor. Through the conductor, whenever a current I is passed, okay, or also we say that the moving charge produce an magnetic field around a conductor, okay, that is called as a magnetic effect of electric current. So first point we have to take here, that is the moving charges or current in a conductor, current flowing in a conductor. Okay, the moving charges or current flowing in a conductor produce magnetic field around the conductor. Okay student, so this point you have to remember, right? So what happened here, whenever we pass a current or also we say that charges, okay, whenever a current is passed through a conductor, means moving charges, we say that is moving charges. So moving charges can create a magnetic field around a conductor, and this is first observed by the scientist, that is what, Hans Christian Oersted, in 1820. Okay, he observed this phenomena. Okay, and one question arises in your mind, why the moving charges create an magnetic field? Why moving charges create an magnetic field? It is common question most of the students are asking the class, why it is happened. Okay, what phenomena, why the current have the problem, why current when it pass through a conductor it produces a magnetic field, why the question? And the simple answer is, it is the nature of current or moving charges, anything you say, right? So here see simple one, first point here, Hans Christian Oersted is a scientist. In 1820 he found that whenever a charge or moving charge or current flowing in a conductor produce a magnetic field around the conductor, and that effect is called as magnetic effect of electric current, students. Okay, the different effects: heating effect of electric current, magnetic effect of electric current, and a chemical effect of electric current. So it is magnetic effect of electric current, right? And one question arises, why the moving charges create a magnetic field? So simple answer, it is a property, it is a nature of current, it is a natural property of current, it is the nature of the current or moving charge to produce a magnetic field. Okay, this is the one of the answer for this question. Why means it is because of its nature, that is the nature of the charges. right? So now after that, we have to come across the very important point here. Okay, that is magnetic field, right? So before going to magnetic field, I'd introduce one important point here, that is magnetic lines. Magnetic lines. What is mean by magnetic lines? So in the magnetic field, when we represent a magnetic field, we draw a lines, and that lines are called as magnetic lines. So what is the definition of magnetic lines? Very important. In examination, define magnetic lines. Okay, magnetic lines. That is answer is, it is an imaginary line. Okay, it is a imaginary lines which are represents magnetic field around a magnet, right? Imaginary line. There is not a real, it is present, it's an imaginary line, right? So magnetic lines are, it is an imaginary line which are represent magnetic field around a magnet, right? It's imaginary. Like example, in the light chapter we are studied, that is principal axis, okay, which is passes through the center of an mirror, or that is from the pole of a mirror, right? And that principal axis is not really present. If you practically observe lens, there is no principal axis we observe. It is an imaginary line. For a practical, in theoretical, we use the line for drawing the ray diagrams. But actually, the lines is not present. It is an imaginary line we made. Like that, the magnetic field also not have any lines. When you hold a bar or any magnet, there is no visibility of the magnetic field. No, you not observe. You feel the magnet, but you not observe the lines. It is an imaginary concept we have been generated to find the one field here, right? So it is imaginary lines which is represent the magnetic field, which is used to represent the magnetic field around a magnet, right, students? So here again, one point we have concluded here. So then, what is mean magnetic field here? So see here, magnetic field definition, that is very important for examination. Magnetic field. Okay. So what is magnetic field? It is a field in which the strength of the magnetic force can be detected. So that is meaning of the magnetic field. Means field nothing but its area, its circumference. In under that circumference only the field can be act. Okay, so that is called a magnetic field. For example, if I say, I am a science teacher, and then I am a science teacher for my school only. Okay, for other school there is a different science teacher is there. So means that my circumference is for my school only. Like that, it is a field. My field is only, I am responsible only for my SSC students of my class. Okay, in other school is there, they are not my responsible. Okay, if they pass or fail, it is not my responsible, but my area is only of my, under my school SSC students. Like that, my area it is, so that under only I work. So like that, the every magnetic field has the area, and when they enter into the area, then only we detect the magnetic field. In the outside the area, we cannot detect it. For example, see, if it is a point, it is a magnet, point A is a magnet, and it is the area. It is the area. Okay, if I come inside the area, then only I can detect the magnetic field. If I am present outside of this area, I does not, okay, find the magnetic field. So means that the area under which the magnetic field can be detected, that is called as a magnetic field. Okay, that magnetic field. So that is magnetic field lines, and then magnetic field is also called as magnetic field lines, and it is a magnetic field. So again repeated, what is magnetic field? Magnetic lines, it is an imaginary line which can be represent magnetic field around magnet. And then what is magnetic field here? So magnetic field is a field in which a strength of the magnetic force can be detected, right? So that is very important, students, you have to be remember. Now let us see the another very important concept, that is the magnetic field, magnetic field lines around बार मैग्नेट, ओके, अराउंड बार मैग्नेट. ओके स्टूडेंट, दिस इज अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन एग्जामिनेशन. दे आस्क अबाउट ड्रॉ द मैग्नेट फील्ड अराउंड ए बार मैग्नेट फॉर 1 मार्क्स, राइट. सो लेट अस सी स्टूडेंट्स, let us try to understand this concept here. See, we know that bar magnet, so that it is shape, okay, magnet shape is there. So there are different shape of magnet is there, okay. Actually there are, one is the artificial magnet and one is natural magnet, okay. And the natural magnets are irregular in shape, but the artificial magnets are shape, okay. Some are in card as bar shape, that is rectangular face are there, bar shape, and some have horse shape, and some have double dumbbell shape, like, okay, some have round shape, so circle shape, spherical shape. So there are different artificial magnets are there. So I selected one magnet that is present in syllabus, that is bar magnet. Okay, if I draw the bar magnet, it is like that. It is a look like a rectangle. It is exact rectangle or cuboid. In 3D we say it is cuboid. Okay, in 1D it is called as a rectangle, right? So when it is a bar magnet, and bar magnet is also like a battery. See here, in the battery we have two terminals, one is positive terminal and one negative terminal, right? So like that, here also we observe two terminals are there, one and here one terminal, and it is one terminal, right? So in the battery we one terminal is plus and one terminal is minus, but here not plus minus, here we take one is yes, one is n and one is yes, right? So students, let us see, it is a bar magnet, and bar magnet having, it is a bar magnet and bar magnet have two poles. That is first point to remember. Bar magnet have two poles. The number one pole is called as N pole. It is a shortcut. What is N here? N stand for North Pole. Okay students, N stand for North Pole. You have to remember that one. North Pole. Also called as a North Seeking Force. The Seeking Pole. Also same. Okay, N pole shortcut. Or North Pole or North Seeking Pole, and we commonly use North Pole and North Pole. Okay, North Seeking Pole is not used so much. Okay, but we can remember that one. And next one is, it is one second one is a S Pole. What is mean by S Pole here? It is a Superman? No, it is an South Pole. Okay, it is a South Pole, and it is also called as what? Right, that is right. That is South Seeking Force, Seeking Pole, South Seeking Pole. So this is the very two terminals having bar magnet, and the two terminals are named, one name is N pole and one name is S pole. N pole is a North Pole and S pole is a South Pole. So let us one question, and again, why we make N pole and S pole? Because we have four directions. One is N, one is S, and one is East and one is West. Why we not take East and West? So what is the answer here? Why we not take East pole and West pole? Why we take N and S pole? That is very important question arises in the mind. So answer is because simply when we suspended freely a bar magnet, it always comes to rest at the direction of North Pole and South Pole. For example, like that, I can make a thread here and I tie a here one bar magnet. So and I freely suspended this magnet with an thread. So observe that after rotation of the bar magnet, after when it is come rest, it is always in N and South Pole. Okay, the side which is towards North Pole is North Pole, and the side which is South Pole is called South Pole. That is one. That is we name it is as a North Pole and South Pole. If you want to kept it a West and East, it is again turn and come to rest at the North and South Pole only. Why? Because if it is Earth having a greatest magnet, big magnet, and that magnet attract this magnet. Earth magnet, it attract this magnet in which one? N and S direction. So that is why we name the N pole and South Pole here. Okay, why? Because of when a freely suspended bar magnet, it is always come to rest at the North Pole and the South Pole. Because of that, we are named one terminal is the North Pole and one terminal is the South Pole. North Pole is always toward the North seeking and South is toward the South seeking pole. So this is our student about the basic introduction about the bar magnet. Now let us see, we actually study about what magnetic field around a bar magnet. Okay, so as title we have right here, magnetic field around a bar magnet here. So see here, how I draw this one, this arrow, neatly I first take an my magnet and one side is N or one side is S. Okay, see here, we write these curve lines. Okay, we observe that these curve lines, neatly draw the curve lines, do not cut each other, okay, maintain some distance, okay. So these right, also here some lines. So see here, this is, these lines are called as magnetic lines, magnetic field lines. Okay, magnetic field lines, and we observe that these magnetic field lines are curve lines, and another point you observe that they not intersect means what, cut to each other. Okay, they not cut, intersect to each other. So that is two very important point we have to be learned here. Okay, before going to these explanation, first come to the here. So this is called as incomplete, it is actually incomplete diagram. Now we have to now mention the what is direction of the magnetic field. Why? Because of magnetic field is vector quantity, students. Magnetic field is vector quantity. We know that what is vector quantity, which have both magnitude and direction. Magnitude nothing but strength, and direction nothing but it is from one point to another point direction. So we observe the direction of magnetic field here. So we observe that by convention, the direction of the magnetic field is from, the magnetic fields are emerging at north side, North Pole. Right, it is coming from the North Pole, like that. Coming from the North Pole, and enter into the South Pole. Means what? Merge. Okay, merge into South Pole. So now the diagram is completed totally. Right. So correctly observe that. So outside the magnet, right? The magnetic field, how much it is? North to South. But inside it is South to North, right? So two point here mentioned, two here. Okay, students. So one point is clear. Bar magnet and these core lines indicate the magnetic field, and these core lines are never intersect to each other. And the magnetic field is a vector quantity, means which having the direction and magnitude. Right. Now again I write very important point here. If you observe the diagram carefully, write one point here. Direction of magnetic field outside the bar magnet is from North Pole to South Pole, correct? From North Pole to South Pole, right? This one point remember. Now I come to the inside. Okay, this inside. So see a second point. The direction of magnetic field inside the bar magnet is from see here, from south to north, is from south pole to North Pole. Right, student, these two points you have to remember carefully. So here, see, there are two type of questions arises here. One, in examination, if they ask what is the direction of the magnetic field, that much only they ask means you have to write this is correct. Outside you mention it, not inside mention. In examination, simple they ask what is the direction of magnetic field. So you have to mention this one, that is a North Pole to South Pole. If they separately ask what is the direction of the magnetic field inside and outside, means you have to mention these two. But generally they ask what is the direction of magnetic field, that is enough. There is no concept of inside or outside sentence. There is no, they are not asking about inside or outside. They simply say about what is the direction of the magnetic field. So in that case you have to write North Pole to South Pole is the direction of the magnetic field. But if they mention particularly what is the direction of the magnetic field inside and outside, so you have to mention this. Inside it is south to north, you observe here, south to north, and the outside it is north to south. It is actually reverse. So that is point you have to be reversed. That is take a revision, right? So this point is, and this diagram, draw the magnetic field around a bar conductor. This is now complete. N, S, and then lines, and then directions. Some of the students, they forget to write direction, and some students forget to write the N and S. So in that case you lose your marks. Okay, it is simply for 2 marks, then use again marks means it is a bad luck for you. Okay, so because of that, please practice the diagrams, right? So next point here, see students, after studying the magnetic field, we conclude some lines here, some points here. See what the first point we get here, we observe that magnetic field lines are never intersect each other. In the diagram you see, in the diagram see that they are not intersect with each other. Any line, see, whenever see the line, they never intersect with each other. What try? So here see, it is because it is I write the answer like that. It is because the magnetic field lines are never intersect to each other. It is because if imagine if they are intersect to each other, then it means the needle of the compass that is used to find the direction of magnetic field. Okay, the needle of the compass will show the two direction. Okay, show the two direction which is not possible. Okay, which is not possible. So see, one needle can show only one direction at a one time. I can show like this south, but this is again so north, it is not possible. So a needle can be show at a one time north and second time maybe south, but at the same time show both direction, it is not possible actually, right? So that is why it means they never intersect to each other. If the needle can show the same direction, two direction at the same time, means if they intersect. But actually practically observe that they never it is possible. It never case, it is not, we observe that the needle can show the so both direction the same time, it is not possible. We not observe like that. So it means that they never intersect to each other. Okay, that is we have to write here. So why magnetic field lines are never intersect to each other means the magnetic field lines are never intersect to each other because if they are intersect to each other, imagine that intersect to each other, then it means what that it means the needle of the compass will show the two direction at its time, which is not possible. So this point you have to be remember, students. Okay, so magnetic field lines are one hour intersect, so that is the answer, right? So this is right here in your book. That is very important concept. Maybe this time they ask about that, why the magnetic field lines are never intersect to each other. So practice this one. Okay students, now come to the properties of magnetic field here. Okay, properties of magnetic field, properties of a magnetic field. So right, first property, that is we already studied here, I take revision. By convention, by convention, the field lines are the magnetic field lines are emerge from North Pole and merge at South Pole. Right, students? So this is the answer. Now let us see the one property. And second property, magnetic field lines are curve lines. Okay, they are curve lines. Right, the third one is magnetic field lines are strongest at pole. Strong, it means at a pole it is strong and weak far from the magnet. When we go far from the magnet, the magnetic field is weak, but at the pole the magnetic field is highest at the pole. Next, third one is see here, magnetic field lines are vector quantity. Okay, vector quantity means that it has both magnitude and direction, students. So these are some very important properties of the magnetic field. So you have to remember, an examination for 2 marks, write the properties of magnetic field. So last year examination, they ask about that, what is the magnetic field, draw the magnetic field around a bar conductor and write the properties of the bar magnet for 4 marks. Okay, properties of any, you write these 4 means, you get full marks. Right, students? So this is very important and easy concept to write, actually today cover. Okay, today I'll cover very easy concept about the magnetic effect of electric current. Right, so these are some points you have to be remember. Okay, so now let us take the another very important concept about the magnetic field. That is title, new title. Here the title is magnetic field magnetic field due to a current through a straight conductor. So that is very important point you have to remember. So see here, I take a straight conductor. When a current I is passed through a conductor, what happened? We say that whenever a current is passed through a conductor, it produces a magnetic field around the conductor. So the magnetic field here, see here, I write here some points. Current carrying conductor produce magnetic field around the conductor. Clear? One point. So now see, we observe that in the bar magnet, the magnetic field lines are curve lines, but here they're not in curve. The magnetic field here, magnetic field lines around a straight conductor are concentric circles. What is the concentric circles? Here see, concentric circle definition. Concentric circles. Circles having same center but different radius. For example, like that. If a current I is passed through a conductor, now at this point a field is generated like that. it is a one circle and same center another circle. So we observe that the center is same, but there is different radius. There is a differencing. So from the center, when go away from the center, when you go away from the center, the what happened? The constant circles are increasing. The field lines area is what increasing. So this is, students, whenever a current carrying conductor produces a magnetic field, and that magnetic fields are in the form of which concentric circle? That is very important. See here, the magnetic field around a bar magnet is a curve lines. That is important. And second point is the magnetic field around a straight conductor. How much it is? It is in the shape of concentric circles. So what is the shape? Examination, multiple choice question. So what is the shape of magnetic field around a straight conductor carrying current? Right? What is question? What is the shape of the magnetic field around a current carrying conductor? That is what? Concentric circles. Means center one, same but different radii. Right, students? Now, in the magnetic fields around a bar magnet, we know the direction from north pole to south pole. But where is the north and south? There is no north and there is no south. So what is the direction of it? Is like that or it is like that? Okay, circle nothing but it may start to rotate. It rotates in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. How do you find the direction of current here? Okay, so here we use simple rule, that is called as right hand thumb rule. So that will be take later. Okay, now I not take direction of magnetic field here, I can take it later. But you have to remember, we also show the direction here. Maybe circles are rotating clockwise directions, maybe circles are rotating in anti-clockwise direction. That is depend on the direction of current here. So how do you find if the current is upward, it is clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction? If the current is downward, so what is the direction of magnetic field here? It is change. When the direction of current is changed, the direction of magnetic field also change. And that concept I let's take later. But first come to here, one is concentric circles. Okay, one point C here. Observe C. Okay, after that, see here. I take a point A on the circle 1. I take a point B on the circle 2. I take a point C or the circle C 3 and D and E like that. Now the different points are having different distance from the center, right? Which point is near to this center? That is what A point, right? Simple radius. So you observe that the A point is very near to the conductor. So in that, the point that is near to a current carrying conductor experience a strongest strength of magnetic field lines. That is very important. Means what? We observe that when the distance is less, the magnetic field is what? Magnetic field is what? Strength is more. Experiences strongest strength. Means more strength. So we get, if I take a alphabet, see here, if I can represent the magnetic field with a B. Okay? The magnetic field, see here, magnetic field strength is inversely proportional to the distance. Clear concept, students? See here. Here I can decrease the distance. What happened here? Distance decrease, the strength increase here. So I can say that magnetic field strength is represented with alphabet B is inversely proportional to the distance. Right? So this point you have to remember. Right? In the examination, they give the diagram and ask at which point the magnetic field is more. So you have to check the distance. The distance less means the magnetic field is more. Then say why. So you can explain like that. The magnetic field strength is increased when the point is near to a conductor. Okay. The distance is less, the magnetic field is more. The distance is more, the magnetic field is less. Now second C. Okay, A is finished. Now C, B, C, D, E. So see that, tell me that at which point that there is this lowest magnetic field. So you get a correct answer, that is what, at point E. So okay, why? Because of it is a more distance increase, the magnetic field strength is decrease. Okay, distance increase, magnetic field strength is decrease. Like the student here happened. So I can say that B is inversely proportional to the distance. Now this is okay. Now this point. Now let us see another very important point, that is, okay, another very important point. If I increase the current, what hai? I increase the current. Increase the current in the conductor. I increase the current in the conductor. So I observe that. What I observe? I observe that magnetic field lines are magnetic field line strength is increase. So what does mean? Current increase, field increase. So means that the magnetic field B is directly proportional to the current. So that is very important, you have to remember in the examination. How do you increase the magnetic field in a straight conductor? Simple question. How do you increase the magnetic field lines around a straight conductor? Simple, by increase a magnetic field. Right? So important point, you have to be remember, students. Okay. So see here, some points I take here. How do you, so one point, how do you increase magnetic field around a current carrying conductor? Okay, so simple answer is by increasing the current, that is B proportional to I. Okay students, so this point you have to be remember. So how do you increase the magnetic field around a current carrying conductor? Simply by increasing strength of the current. If the current increases, the magnetic field also increases, because it is directly proportional. So this point student you have to be remember. Right, so this is the simple point you have to be remember. In the examination, sometimes they ask like that, they give the diagram, right? They give the one straight conductor and current I is passing. So now this is a point A from the distance R1, that is radius, and another point B is there from the distance R2. Now tell me at which point the magnetic field is more and at which point the magnetic field is less. So your answer is correct, that is the magnetic field is more at A and less at B. Why? The reason is the magnetic field is more at A because the distance of the A is lesser with the conductor, and the magnetic field at the B is less because of the distance between the point B and the conductor is more. So more distance, less magnetic field. Here A and conductor less distance is more magnetic field. Again I repeated, why the magnetic field at A is increased? We say that at the A the magnetic field is more. Why? It is because of A having lesser distance with the conductor. Right? Why the magnetic field is less at the point B? Because of the distance between conductor and the B point is more. So that is why if the distance is more, the field is less. You have learned here. So that is very important, student. You have to be remember. So how do you increase the magnetic field? By increasing the current. Right, so that is very important point you have to be remember about a straight conductor carrying current. So that is today's last point, that is very important concept. I explain here, recall that law, that is very important law you have to be remember, that is called Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Okay, right hand thumb rule, that is a very important point you have to be remember, students. So this is the last point we have to be study here, that is a right hand thumb rule. So see here, this also called as Maxwell's cork screw. कॉर्क स्क्रूस स्क्रू रूल द बोथ नेम आर सेम दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज मैक्सवेल क्रॉक स्क्रू रूल और ऑल्सो मैक्सवेल थम राइट हैंड थम रूल और सिंपली राइट हैंड थम रूल एंड वॉट इज द पर्पज ऑफ दिस रूल पर्पज ऑफ दिस रूल टू फाइंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइन्स अराउंड ए straight current carrying conductor. Okay, this is the purpose of using right hand thumb rule, Maxwell right hand thumb rule or Maxwell cork screw thumb rule. So what is the purpose why you use this rule? The purpose of this rule is to find the direction of the magnetic field lines around the straight conductor. So what is statement here? Let us see. Okay, I can write what is the statement of the right hand thumb rule. Okay, this is a purpose, I write this one. Okay, now statement. What is the statement of statement, the last point, that is a statement. Here, statement of this rule, right, the statement here, see, holding a current carrying straight. It is just imagine, do not carry it one. Holding a current carrying straight conductor in your right hand such that thumb indicates the direction of current, then your fingers will wrap around the conductor. Around the conductor in the direction of field lines of magnetic field. Okay, magnetic field. See here, I can draw the diagram. Right. Let us see, this is a straight conductor. Okay, this is a straight conductor. Hold it in the hand, carrying. Now, I take one circle or two circles. For example, I can take two concentric circles. Now, let us see, if it is a straight conductor, I hold in a right hand. Okay, right hand. So, this like that. Okay, thumb like that in upper direction. And this four, all fingers are wrapped the conductor like that. So, this thumb indicates the direction of the current. And if the current is upward direction, so what is the direction of current here? See the anti-clockwise direction. So means what? This shows the direction like that. So it is like that nothing but what? See, hold like that, it is in this side, anti-clockwise direction. So it is the direction of current is like that. The direction of magnetic field is like that, anti-clockwise directions. If I can take a conductor and the direction of current is in downward direction, so what is happening here? If I take like that. Now thumb indicate the current is downward direction and it is what? The magnetic field is clockwise direction. So what happened here? The magnetic field is a clockwise direction like that. The magnetic field clockwise directions. So like that, the direction of current is indicated by thumb and the all fingers indicate the direction of magnetic field. If the current is upward, the direction is anti-clockwise direction, the magnetic field lines. And if the current is downward, then we observe that is a clockwise direction. So see here, that is a statement, holding a current carrying straight conductor in your right hand such that thumb indicates the direction of the current and then your fingers will wrap on the conductor. These four fingers, that is four fingers, wrap on the conductor in the direction of the field lines of the magnetic field. which shows the direction of the magnetic field. So these points have to be remembered, students, right? So this is all about the very important concept about the starting concept of the magnetic field I explained today. So here there is no so many questions are there. In the NCERT exercise you observe some questions, so that I read here. Why does compost metal get deflected when brought near magnetic field? Okay, the answer is simple. It is because of due to the magnetic field force. Okay, when I take a bar magnet and take compass, which is used to the device which is used to find the direction, when you take compass near to the bar magnet, we observe the deflection, and that deflection is due to the magnetic field force. That is answer, simple. The deflection in the bar magnet is due to the magnetic field force. Okay, force of magnetic field. One, it is another very important question is there. Draw the magnetic field lines around a bar magnet, that already I explained here. List the properties of the magnetic field, that is also explained here. Direction, vector quantity, okay, that also explained here. And these are all, why does two magnetic field lines are never intersect each other? So that is also I can explain here. So there is no so many questions are there in this concept. Simple, they ask about what is magnetic field lines and what is magnetic field. Then draw the bar magnet and their magnetic field lines diagram, and then ask about why does the curl line, the magnetic field lines are never intersected to each other. That one point they ask, and then one is diagram of bar magnet, and then after that the strength of the magnetic field. Okay, they give the straight conductor and ask about at which point the strength of a conductor is magnetic field is more. So you take a straight conductor, and if the point is near to the conductor, it is a strength is more, and if the point is away from the conductor, then strength is weak. So you can find the distance. If distance is more, the strength is less. If the distance is less, strength is more. And then another question, how do we increase the strength of a magnetic field around a straight conductor carrying current? Means by increasing the strength of a current. If you increase the strength of a in a straight conductor, if you increase the strength of a current, then the, what happened here, the magnetic field is also increases. So that is point you have to be remember. So the straight conductor, the distance is more, the strength is less. The distance is less, the strength is more, inversely proportional. And the current is increases, the magnetic field also increases. So that is some point related to the straight conductor carrying current. After that, you have to find out the direction of the current in the straight conductor, because of it is a concentric circles. Maybe circle rotate in the anti-clockwise directions or clockwise directions. So how do you find the direction? By using the simple rule, that is the Maxwell right hand thumb rule, or also called as Maxwell corkscrew rule, in which the thumb indicate the direction of current and the forefinger indicate the direction of magnetic field, students. So this is a very important point. You have to remember, direct questions are there. Please solve all the questions related to this concept. Okay, so this is the first video of this revision chapter, this magnetic field of electric current, here close here. And the next video we can take some more other concept of this chapter. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video.